the lethality of their power is greater than ever. Their capacity to impose control over the politically awakened masses of the world is at a historical low. In earlier times, it was easier to control a million people than physically to kill a million people. Today, it is infinitely easier to kill a million people than to control a million people.
I hear the word democracy a lot. We have to make the world safe for democracy. We have to bring democracy and freedom to all these nations in the Middle East that we've helped to overthrow their regimes, their governments, kick out the dictators that we put in place and funded. And in 1776, we declared our independence from England, but we've never really been free from the banking forces, and the Rothschilds have worked to take away our sovereignty through their agents and bring in a world government. They've been doing this long before the founding of the United States, and in 1871 they incorporated their business in the District of Columbia Corporation, the United States of America Corporation. This is information that is occulted and hidden. It's not in any history books that are given to you in school, but the information is out there to find if you look hard enough. And what's happened to our constitutional republic, where our government, our limited government, had a sole purpose of protecting the rights, property, and freedom of the people, has turned to a government that is encroaching on all of the rights of the people, taking their property, and using authoritarian means, and then taxing us to worse conditions than it was under English rule, British rule, excuse me. But we, in essence, are still a colony of the British Empire for the way the banking interests control us. Certainly over the last 100 years, the Federal Reserve, which is owned by international bankers, have worked to fund and subsidize and support communism and socialism. The foundations have worked to educate or indoctrinate the schools for education and medicine, history specifically in medicine. The media is all controlled by these same forces who are intent upon the people embracing the concept of a one-world solution, a global solution for all our problems. That's the way we must think. We must think globally. This is globalism. To understand the future, we must look to the past. Past is prologue. Here's some interesting facts from the past. This is Milton William Cooper in 1991, shortly before or during the presidential campaign of the 1991 or 1992. It's prior to Clinton being elected. And it's a very eye-opening interview.
You have to understand the difference between capitalism, socialism, communism, what all of these things really mean. You have to understand that what the difference is between right wing and left wing. People, they use these phrases all the time, and they don't even know what these things mean. And it's just incredible to me to hear a socialist calling someone else a Nazi. Because Nazi means National Socialism. So here's a socialist calling a right wing guy a Nazi, when what he should be calling the right wing guy is anarchist. People on the right want no control. Mm-hmm. They're really anarchists.
Okay? So they would, in theory then, or in fact, be in opposition to this ultimate movement.
Yes.
Whereas in appearance, they would be the ones behind it.
Well, when you have a misunderstanding of what the terms mean, yes.
Okay.
Right wing, on the far right, is total anarchy. They don't want anybody controlling anything that they do, and they believe that people are responsible enough that the world can exist without government.
Okay.
are the very minimal government that it would take to. On the far left, on the other hand, they believe that the government should be in total control and should be supply man with all of his needs.
Well, creating a whole society that's dependent.
Right. A republic is somewhere in the middle. It's governance by laws. Laws are decided by representatives who are elected by the people. And according to the theory, the representatives will do what is right, whether they get elected or not, because it's not really a democracy. A democracy is far left. People don't understand. We don't live in a democracy. This country is not a democracy. It is a republic. A democracy is ruled by the mob. The mob always votes themselves every kind of benefit that they can vote themselves. And whenever you do that, it means large, tremendously overpowering government in control.
They vote themselves into dependency.
That's it. They vote themselves into a dictatorship is what they do, where they lose all of the benefits that they intended to vote themselves into in the first place.
Okay.
And democracies are extremely dangerous to minorities, because if the majority of people don't like you, they're going to vote that they kill you, and they can, you know, that's it. Democracies are dangerous. Democracies are socialists. Democracies are communism. That's what communism is. The definition of communism is everybody doing according to their talents and receiving according to their need. And it doesn't work. We already know it doesn't work. Men, by his inherent nature, is greedy. So those at the top always end up having everything, and those at the bottom end up having nothing in communism. Socialism is different. Socialism usually ends up in a dictatorship, in a very controlling dictatorial government which even owns the people that it governs, so that those who live in fear of not having are provided for what they need, and in turn they worship this oppressive government. Socialists are children who went out into the world, took a look around and said, I can't handle it, and went home to daddy.
Okay.
Daddy, protect me. Daddy, feed me. Daddy, loan me your car. Daddy, tuck me in at night. Socialists are scared little children who are irresponsible, can't stand on their own two feet, and need daddy to take care of them.
Okay.
Okay?
Now we got the...
But what happens when you go home to daddy and daddy does all these things for you? Doesn't it mean that you have to do what daddy tells you to do?
True.
Doesn't it mean you have to be in when daddy tells you to be in? Doesn't it mean that you can't drive the car to the next town if daddy tells you you can't? Doesn't it mean that if daddy tells you to take out the trash, you better take out the trash? Are you beginning to understand the concept? Mm-hmm. When you ask for favors from daddy, you have to give up freedom in return.
Right. Okay.
So socialism always leads to repression of liberty, freedom, equality. All of those things fly out the window, so that you can have free health care, so that you can have a place to live but you don't have to pay the rent, so that you can have food given to you by the state. And that's where we're headed. Right in this country right now, we're almost totally socialist, and now people are screaming for a national health care policy.
Right.
Health care insurance. Anarchists believe that they can be responsible, that they won't hurt other people.
Okay.
That your freedom never ends until it begins to infringe upon someone else's freedom. And that no one should have any control over that. That there should be no speed limits on the highways. The problem is that, again, just like on the socialist side, you have people over here that are human. And human condition means that ultimately somebody's not going to be responsible. That they're going to drive too fast when they've had too much to drink, and they're going to kill innocent people. The answer is a balance. You know, the law of the universe says this. It's a law of physics, really, and everybody can understand it. For every action, there is an equal but opposite reaction. There can be no good unless there is evil. There can be no man without a woman. You understand
right.
the concept?
Based on that, the theory of a utopia here on Earth is corrupt. right away.
Absolutely.
It does. It goes against the laws of physics.
It goes against the law of the universe that there must be two opposing forces all the time, in every instance, because that's what makes the universe work.
Mm-hmm.
That's what makes everything work. What we need to do is stop trying to go way over here and establish some utopia of freedoms, or way over here to establish some repression of freedom so that we make sure that we got something on the table to eat,
mm-hmm.
and strike a balance between the two that works. And stop withholding information. What makes it difficult for anyone to succeed or live, or for us to really come together and have peace in this world, are all of these people who think that they are the guardians of the secrets of the ages, and have only them have truly mature minds, so only them are worthy of knowing the secrets and the real science and the real metaphysics and all of these things. So they repress it and they keep it secret. So the rest of us live out our lives and we don't know the truth of what life is really all about. Therefore, we're always stumbling over each other and getting in each other's way and doing the things that we profess that we don't want to do.
Mm-hmm.
Simply because we don't have access to the truth. If we had access to the truth. Now, I got to tell you this. Back when these men first began establishing these societies, these mystery schools, and suppressing information, the common man was uneducated, did not have an intellect capable of understanding these secrets. They were really beasts of burden, for the most part, mm-hmm. and they lived their whole life in toil.
Right.
But things are not that way now. Most people have a good education. They have a good mind. They're capable of understanding if they're taught, and if they're taught correctly. And I think it's time to teach people what the truth is and quit hiding it, so that we can come together as one humanity and make a balance and live together in a balance. You know, evil's never going to disappear.
Mm-hmm.
Neither is good. But we can maintain a balance and life can be good. Instead of swinging back in this tremendous battle between these two opposing, radical, extreme ends of the scale. That's got to stop. I've never understood why somebody would join together in this band of people and call himself a Democrat and not vote for anybody else if they're not a Democrat. That concept is beyond my understanding. Mm-hmm. And Republicans and libertarians and populists and communists and socialists and this and that, and blacks and whites and the Indians, and there are so many sects and groups and segments, and we're so fragmented that getting together is going to really be difficult.
Mm-hmm.
But we've got to do it, because if we don't wake up and do it ourselves, these men who meet in secret and plot the manipulations are going to do it whether we want it or not, and they're going to do it at the point of a gun.
Mm-hmm.
And they're going to take away everybody's freedom because they don't consider us responsible.
Capable of having that freedom.
Are capable. Are even of using our intellect. So they'll put us in shackles and control us and force us to be peaceful.
Mm-hmm.
That's what the plan is, and that's what the New World Order is all about.
I'd assume now that they'll know about us.
Of course they will. They probably already know about you if you've been exposing the truth on your show.
Would you assume that our phone lines would be bugged at this point?
I don't know. I doubt it. They don't really consider you to be a threat unless you develop a large political following.
Oh, okay.
So, unless you have a large political following, you're not considered to be a threat to them. Because they figure that the people are too stupid to listen to you anyway. And generally, they're right.
So we're in the process of educating people, then.
Yeah.
Is the best thing.
Education is 60 or 70% of the battle.
Yeah.
Because people automatically begin to do the right things once they learn what the truth is.
They're educated to it.